There's nothing quite as satisfying as growing your own food, but it's even better when you can grow something to flavor your food and get a fragrant garden in the process. We're out here at Pike Nurseries this morning with Mara Ammons to learn how to grow our very own herb garden. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, this is an instance where I wish the viewers were right here because just seeing this does not do it justice.
It does not. It smells divine right now, and we have lots of options for y'all already. And of course, these herbs are a perfect match for a touch of color. So don't forget your flower gardens. You can have a little bit of herbs to make them even more fragrant and usable.
That's perfect when you're outdoors enjoying that scent.
Oh yeah, for sure. If you don't have much space though, we always can plant some herbs in a narrow pot inside for your windowsill. Because maybe that would be working for you right there in the kitchen. It's easily accessible, so that'd be nice to have.
So they need to be in a spot though that's getting a lot of sun.
By the way, they need the sun.
Okay.
They need lots and lots of sun. These guys would not be happy in a shady part of your yard. So make sure you give it a sunny spot. And we have lots of options for you to choose from right now. We have different kinds of sage. We have all kinds of mint. And we, of course, have larger varieties that can go in your yard and in your landscape,
okay,
like rosemary. Rosemary does great. It's evergreen year-round. So that's an option as well.
And you have so many different varieties. I see that you're planting some of them together. What do we have here?
So this is super fun. This is a cocktail garden, and I've chosen a couple of different plants that I like to use in a couple of our mixed drinks for summertime,
okay,
and spring as well. We've got mojito mint here for, of course, mojitos. And then we've got some rosemary in the back, which you can score your olives for a dirty martini or something like that. And of course, you've got this pineapple sage, which is fragrant and beautiful and something fruity. So you can go with it. One little hint that I was thinking about when I touched this mint. Mint can be very aggressive.
Okay.
And you need to make sure that it stays nice and tight in your container because otherwise it'll take over. I literally plant it in its pot right inside of my container and let it go.
Okay, so most of these you can mix in the same container, but it might be beneficial just keep that one in a separate one all together.
Yes, some folks might be having trouble with cilantro and maybe some parsley. It's probably because they need more water than, say, a lavender or rosemary.
Mm-hmm.
So keep that in mind. Maybe a drought-tolerant mix for your container gardens could handle some rosemary or lavender.
All right, well, thanks for the inspiration, Mara.
Thank you.